It's day 11 and thanks for sticking with me. In yesterday's video, day 10, we talked about prospecting reluctance. Well, today we're going to talk about another common problem. Dun, dun, dun. I don't sing well. Setting appointments. But inside this short video is the buried lead you won't want to miss, so keep watching. As a sales rep, do you ever wish,
gee, it would be really nice if someone made my appointments for me?
I know I have. At the opposite end of the selling spectrum, inside sales reps, do you ever wish,
gee, it would be really nice if account executives wouldn't cancel appointments I worked so hard to set for them?
No matter what side of the selling spectrum you're on, every single person should get in the habit of setting their own appointments. Do you need to get over the fear of setting appointments? As I said in day 10, the main reason you're fearful when selling is because you're out of practice or haven't taken the time to really hone the skills that you're weak in. Here's the buried lead. You've heard me say this. Practice in doing creates competency. Competency creates confidence. Work on your weak areas to become competent. So if your selling problem is you're just lousy at setting appointments, you're never going to improve and become good at it if you don't do it, if you don't practice setting appointments. And you must practice consistently every day in order to become really good at it. It's just like playing golf. You can't play once a month and expect to become an accomplished golfer. It's necessary to practice at the driving range and play each week consistently if you want to improve. It's the same when developing your selling skills, and frankly, any skill in life takes practice. Now that we've corrected your mindset, here are three quick tips on setting appointments. Number one, when setting the appointment, your only goal is to set the appointment. Your goal is not to sell. Number two, don't be a talking brochure while setting the appointment. Again, your goal is only to set the appointment. Number three, if the prospect does show interest by asking questions, and you've clarified with the prospect that they do have 20 to 30 minutes to discuss, only then proceed. In the description area below is a link where you can download the support document for this video that outlines a script to follow should you need one. And above me is another video you can watch on this very subject. Okay, give me a thumbs up and be sure to be the multiplying force and share this 30-day challenge far and wide. If you're new to my channel, welcome. I'm glad to have you. Why don't you hit the subscribe button and notification bell so you don't miss the next video in the 30-day challenge. Now remember, sales is a journey, not a quick trip around the block. I'll see you tomorrow for day 12. Are you a needy salesperson? Find out tomorrow. Don't miss this one. And thanks for watching.